students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our science session. So in today's science session, we are going to start our new lesson, and the name of the lesson is Separation of Substances. Okay, so the lesson number 5 and the name of the lesson is what? Separation of Substances. So why it is necessary to do the separation, or what is mean by the substances, what is mean by the different constituents are there or different components are there, why we are separating all these substances from each other, that all the things we are going to see in this particular lesson. So as if we talk about our surrounding, then in our surrounding there are this number of the things are there which are the mixture. Now mixture means what? The thing which is made up of the different substances. For example, if we talk about the air, so as we know, the air is a mixture of different gases, because the so many different gases are present in the air, and along with that different gases we can tell as the air is present everywhere. Okay, like that also we can say the sea water is also the one type of the mixture. It contains the more amount of the salt and water. Soil also having a different components. It contains clay, it contains fine particles, it contains humus. All these are the substances which are present in the soil. So like that, air, soil, sea, water, all these are the different mixtures which are present in our nature. Okay, so let's see what is the exact definition of the mixture. See here, a mixture is a substance that contains two or more pure substances. Okay, what is meant by the mixture? A mixture is a substance that contains two or more than pure substances mixed together in a different proportion. Okay, so for example, we can say that we will take one easy example. For example, bhel. If you are preparing the bhel at home, so as the persons are there, their likes and the dislikes are also different. Someone likes the more amount of the chili in the bhel, so they will add the more amount of the chili in that. Someone likes the sweet, then they will add the more amount of the sugar syrup in the bhel. Okay, so in this way, according to that, we can add the different substances in a different proportion. So the bhel is the one example of what? Mixture. Okay, in that we are adding the puff rice, for that we are calling as a surmure. In that we are adding farsan, onion, then tomato, then coriander, all these things that we are adding into the bhel, and then with along with all these substances we can make one mixture that we are calling as what? Bhel. But all these proportion of their substances are what? Different. Corianders we are adding the small amount, while onion we are adding in a medium amount like that, and the churmure and bhel we are adding in a more amount. So these are the different proportions we are adding the substances, and for that only we are calling as what? Mixture. Next one, the substance which are mixed to form a mixture. Okay, so the substances that we are using to make a mixture are called constituents or components. So here we have taken the example of bhel as a mixture. So in the bhel we are using the puff rice, farsans, or also we are used the onion and the tomato. Then all these are what? Different constituents or components that we have used to make a mixture. Okay, so the substance which are mixed to form a mixture are called the constituents or components. Okay, so from that constituents or the components we can mix in a different proportion, and from that we can make a mixture. Okay, so now we will move for the next point, and the first point from the lesson, that is what? Need for separation of substances in a mixture. So why is it necessary to separate out all these constituents from the mixture? So the need for separation of substances in a mixture, why we have to separate out the different substances from a mixture? In that, first one we are going to see about. So there are the certain reasons, there are the certain necessities are there, and because of that necessity, because of that reasons, we have to separate the substances from the mixture. So the first reason we are going to see in that, that is how to remove harmful substances. So for example, we can say that, so generally whenever we are going to the grocery shop, we are purchasing the more amount of the wheat, rice, or the certain types of the cereals. Okay, but along with that cereals, there are the certain small size of the stones are also present in that cereals. Okay, and that stones are not useful for our body, or we can say that what? They are what? Harmful for our body. So it is necessary to throw throw out or to remove out that harmful substances from that cereal. Which are the harmful substances present in the cereal? We can say that small stones which are present in the cereal, which are harmful to the body, and that we have to remove from the mixture. Okay, so this is the first reason, that is what, to remove harmful substances. Next one we will discuss, that is to obtain useful components. Okay, so if you will take one mixture, in that mixture some are the useful components and some are the non-useful, or some are the components which are not useful for us. So from that mixture we have to remove the useful component. For example, we can say that crude petroleum is a mixture of different components, such as we can say it contains the diesel, petrol, kerosene, okay, different types of the gases. So we separate all these components, we separate out petroleum, petrol, diesel, kerosene, and according to our uses we are using all these things. For example, we can say from the crude oil we separated the petrol and the diesel that we are using as a fuel in the different vehicles. Also from that crude oil we are separating out the kerosene that we are using as a fuel in the chulas. Okay, so in this way, to obtain the useful component from the mixture, to obtain the useful component from the mixture is also the one reason to separate the substances from a mixture. Now the next one and the third one reason we are going to discuss, that is to remove undesirable substances. Okay, so to remove the undesirable substance, for example, as you know, your mother is keeping everyday tea in the morning and in the evening. So once the tea get prepared, or while preparing the tea, she is adding some things in that, or some constituents or the components in that. Okay, so what they are, she is adding, first she is taking the water, in that water she is adding some amount of sugar, then tea powder. Okay, so all these are what, tea, then sugar, all these are what constituents or the components that we are using to make a mixture that we are calling as what, tea. So once the tea get prepared, once it gets started to boil, it, she is using the strainer to strain it. Okay, why? Because the tea powder is not useful, or it is what, undesirable substance from that tea. So it is not useful. Whatever the useful things are present in the tea powder already get dissolved in that water, and now the tea powder is not useful, it is what, undesirable. So she is removing that tea powder from the tea. Okay, so in this way, whatever the undesirable substances are there, for to remove that substances we have to do the separation of the mixture. So these are the certain reasons, for that reasons we have to separate out those substances from a mixture. Okay, now we'll move for the next one, that is methods of separation. But to separate out these constituents or the components from the mixture, it is very important to take or to understand the properties of that components or that constituent. So now we are going to learn about some methods for the separation of the mixture, separation of the components from the mixture. Okay, so first today we will discuss about the separation of solid from a mixture. Now which type of the substances we are going to separate out from the mixture? We are going to separate out solid substance from a mixture. Okay, so the separation of the solid substances from a mixture, in that the first method we are going to discuss, that is what, hand picking. Okay, and which is a very common method that we are usually using in our house. So here in the first reason we have discussed about the rice and the cereals. So when we purchase the rice, that time what, that rice contain the certain types of the stones, okay, which is necessary to remove out from that rice. So for that purpose we are using his hand picking method. So with the help of the hands we can easily remove our, remove that stone, small type of the stones from the cereals or from the rice. So that is what, hand picking. So in which type of the criteria, or there are the certain ways, in that ways only we can use this hand picking method. First one is there, if the mixture is in a small quantity, then only we can use this hand picking method. Next one, if the undesirable substance is having the different color and a different size, then this hand picking method is useful. And also the third one, we can say that if the unwanted substances present in the mixture is in a less amount, then this hand picking method is useful. Okay, So along with all these things, if the mixture is small in amount, if the undesirable substances in a less amount, and if their shape, size and the color is also different, then this hand picking method is useful to separate out the solid substances from a mixture. Okay, next one we will discuss about the threshing. Now what is mean by the threshing? So as we know, there are the different agricultural activities are there. So once the crops are ready, then we are doing harvesting. And after harvesting, the next process comes, that is what? Threshing. Now what happens in the threshing? We are making the bunch of that crops and then we are beating them on the ground or on the stone. Why? To remove the grains from the stalk. To remove the grains from the stalk. And that method is only called as what? Threshing. Okay, that method is only called as threshing. So this threshing can be done with the manually also and with the help of the machines also. So this threshing we can do manually. See how we can do the threshing manually. You can see in the image, the man has the bunch of that crop and they are beating it on the ground. Okay. Also, this threshing can be done with the help of the machine. So the machines like threshers we are using to make the threshing process. Generally, this threshing can be done with the help of the machine if the cultivated area is what? Very large or very big. Okay. So this is about what? Threshing. Now we will discuss about the winnowing. Now what is mean by the winnowing? After threshing, now what? We have separated the grains. But now that grains contain the grain covers also or the seed coat on that grains. Okay, so it is necessary to remove it. So what we are doing? We are allowing that grains to drop down from the certain height. And then we are giving some air to eat. Okay. So with the help of that air, with the help of that wind or the air blow, that light material which are present in the grain can get removed easily from the mixture. So see in the image how the exactly winnowing process can be takes place. So basically this winnowing process is useful to remove the lighter material from the heavier material. So this winnowing method is useful to remove the lighter material from the heavier materials. Okay. So these are the three methods that we are using to separate the solid substances from a mixture, that are hand picking, threshing and winnowing. Okay. So this is all about today. Today we have discussed certain points from the lesson separation of substances. So this is the time to tell you goodbye. Here we will stop. We will meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.